Hey everyone, in this video we are going to break down what nodes are in DaVinci Resolve Fusion page and why they can actually be a much better way to work when you are building complex or advanced motion graphics. So let's get started. When you first open your footage in Fusion, you will notice two nodes already sitting in the node editor, Media In 1 and Media Out 1. Media In is basically your footage. It is pulling in whatever clip you drop on your timeline. Media Out, on the other hand, is your live preview. As you build your design on top of that Media In node, Media Out shows you exactly how it looks in real time. Right above your node editor, you will see a toolbar packed with different nodes. You can just drag and drop into your workspace. These are some of the most commonly used nodes in Fusion. So let's start with a big question. What the heck is a node? Let me bring in the most commonly used one in Fusion, the merge node. Okay, if you look closely, each node has these little shapes on its sides, small squares and colorful triangles. These are basically connectors. They are what allow us to link nodes together using those pipelines you see in the node editor. Fusion makes it easier with color coding. The brown square is the output. That's where the result of the node comes out. The green triangle is the foreground. The yellow triangle is for the background. And the blue triangle is the effect mask. In Fusion, nodes flow from left to the right. You can actually see it in the connector line going from Media In to Media Out. That's the natural direction of the workflow. So you start building your design on the left side and keep moving toward the right until you are done. Alright, let's say you are working on a design and you want to add a node to spice it up. So where do you actually find these nodes? Well, the first place is right here in the toolbar above your node editor. These are the most commonly used nodes. Another quick way is by pressing Shift plus Space, and you can just type the name of your node you are looking for. Super fast. And finally, you can also right click anywhere in the node editor, go to Add Tool, and you will see all the nodes neatly grouped into categories. Now, if you need something from the blur family, just head over to the blur and pick the exact node you want. Alright, enough talk. Let's actually do a quick project so you can see nodes in action. I have got this beautiful drone shot. The footage already looks nice, but I think the shadows, highlights, and midtones could use a little boost. So let's improve it with a color corrector node. Grab a color corrector node from the toolbar, drag it over to the main pipeline, and hover it on the line. When the line changes color, just release it, and boom, the color corrector automatically connects into the main pipeline. When you click on any node, all of its properties will show up right here in the inspector panel. This is where you can make your tweaks and dial in the exact look you want. Alright, let's play around with these settings. I will darken the shadows, lift the highlights, and bring up the midtones. Nice. Now, whenever you are color correcting, it is super important to check the before and after so you can actually see the difference your changes are making. Just toggle this little button off and on to see the before and after. If you want to see both versions side by side, enable the dual viewer. Click the little dot under the Media In node, and that will show you raw footage in the left viewer. On the right, you have got your corrected media out. Now you can directly compare them side by side. Alright, leave the color corrector for now and let's do another quick but super popular project inside Fusion. So first, let's create a rectangle shape. Now in Fusion, anytime you want to create a shape, you will need two nodes. A shape node and a background node. Now connect the output of the rectangle to the input of background. If I click the left view button under the background node, you will see our black rectangle show up in the left view. And in the inspector, you can change its color to anything you like. You can adjust the width and height of the rectangle either by dragging the edges directly or by tweaking the sliders in the inspector. Alright, let's add some text. Grab a text node from the toolbar and click the left view button under it so we can see it in the left view. Type in your text. Now we need to combine our rectangle and text nodes using a merge node. So grab a merge node from the toolbar and drop it into the node editor. Connect the rectangle nodes and the text node to the green and yellow triangles of the merge node. Now that our rectangle and text are connected, let's bring them into the main pipeline. Grab another merge node from the toolbar and hover it over the main pipeline. When the line highlights, just release it and it will connect automatically. Now take the output of the merge 1 and connect it to the green input of this new merge node. And there it is, our rectangle shows up in the final preview. But wait. Where is the text? It's missing. If we look closely, the text is actually there, but it's hidden behind the rectangle. But that's not what we want. We need the text to sit on top of the sheet. This is where the connections really matter. One wrong input and our whole design looks off. Let's check what happened. Our rectangle is plugged into the foreground input, the green one, and our text is connected to the background input, the yellow one. That's the opposite of what we need. So let's fix it. Connect the rectangle to the yellow input, which is the background, and the text to the green input, which is the foreground. And there we go. Now, let's say you don't want your rectangle and text sitting right in the middle of the screen. Maybe you want it down in the lower third, like a title. The hard way would be moving each element one by one, first the rectangle, then the text, but that's a pain, and it usually messes up with your alignment. So instead, let me introduce you to one of the most useful nodes in Fusion. Select your Merge 1 node, then click on the Transform node. Now with just this single transform, you can move your entire design anywhere on screen. Just grab the on-screen handle and drag it to where you want, or use the center X or Y values in the specter for precise placement. Super handy. Let's add a subtle glow around our text. Select your text node, press Shift plus Space, search for a soft glow and hit Add. That's another quick way to bring in a node. Whoa, that's a lot of glow. Reduce the gain to around 0.5. Here is another super useful thing I find myself using all the time, naming your nodes. To rename, just right-click on a node and select Rename, or simply press F2. I will call it Master Trans. Another thing that is a lifesaver in bigger projects is organizing your nodes with underlay nodes. Select the rectangle and background nodes, press Shift plus Space and search for underlay and add it. That creates a box around those nodes. You can resize it just like a rectangle, and if you right click, you can even set a color and rename the group. I hope you found this helpful. If you did, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more Fusion tutorials just like this.